How's it going, everyone? It certainly has been quite some time. I apologize yet again, like always. I come back for a little bit, and then I go away for a little bit, and then I come back for a little bit, and then I go away for a little bit. It's a cycle. I apologize again. I also apologize for not streaming this. I just figured since I can't stream, I might as well just record in a more efficient way. So here we are. Will I come back to streaming? Who the fuck knows? But for now, recording videos and uploading them, it shall be done. So we are back with the House and Fata Morgana. I don't remember how I did the voices, so this is going to be quite interesting. I think I got it. But I may not, so if it does sound different, I apologize. I don't really got anything else to say. I'm not gonna ramble on and on like I usually do. I'm just gonna go ahead and jump right on in. And we're gonna continue. Okay, the road to the truth. Let's do it. I gotta prep my throat. It has been quite a while. I turned my gaze back toward the nun to find her kneeling in front of the pews. I think I pronounced that right, maybe not. I don't know. Sorry. She bows her head and begins to whisper a prayer. Music is still as beautiful as ever. Nice. There's no one else in the chapel. Now's the perfect time to ask. Hearing me approach, she falls silent and turns to face me, wearing her usual, disarming smile.
Hello, Mikael. Mel was just here. He told me everything. Can't turn away a friend of Mel's, now can we? Sorry for turning you down earlier.
No worries. I did a poor job of explaining myself.
So, did you need anything? Oh, let me guess, medicine?
No, I am in perfectly good health.
I figured you were lying.
What? I can ask her about Saint's blood some other time. And while I have a number of questions about the man, she's close with two. Right now, Mel's sister is priority.
That's right, we need to ask about that.
To be honest, I kind of forgot where we were.
But, luckily, I was just now reminded. Perfect.
Are you familiar with Mel's younger sister? She has flaxen hair just like him.
Oh, you mean Nell. Are you her friend too?
I would say we are more...
You're better off just saying you're friends.
Friends, yes.
Coming in clutch!
Hell yeah.
It's good that we have her here with us. Or else he would fail miserably.
Hmm? Well, what about her?
I would like to speak with her. And I was wondering if you might know where I could find her.
Nell should be down at the cottage, I believe.
Cottage.
Yep, that's where I stay too. I don't sleep in the mansion itself.
Huh. Interesting. We didn't learn that before, but I guess now we do. Alright.
So you don't live here, but only work here.
Right. For one, there are men who live here. The Lord likes to show up on occasion too, and we can't have a nun wandering around while he's here.
That's suspicious, my dear. But sure.
What the fuck? All right.
So you and Nell live together then?
Yep. We have about, for about, 6 months or so. Ever since she and Mel showed up.
Oh, okay.
I wanted to let her stay with her brother. But since this is technically church property, we have to keep the boys and girls separate.
Even when they're, like, related by blood, that's... Okay. That's, alright, sure. Whoa, what the fuck ever? Hey, it's your place, your business, I guess. Whatever. I see.
I'm so glad to hear Nell's got a friend, though.
What?
She's not from around here, so she doesn't have many acquaintances. And with how sick she can get, she doesn't spend much time outside. Which is a shame, because she's such a sweet little girl. I'm her friend, of course, but I've got responsibilities. I can only be around so often.
Right, right.
So I'm sure she'd be delighted to have someone else to talk to.
I guess. It would be my pleasure, my dear. Could you, tell me the way to the cottage, then?
Oh, sure. It's not that far from here. You go down...
And we skip. Skip the directions. Thank you. I'm a little goofy. I'm in a goofy mood. The directions I got from the nun led me to the place I know from my own time. It's the same building where the man who had been ordered to keep me under surveillance stayed. Interesting. Sunlight seeps relentlessly through the trees, and I find myself having to look down at my feet as I follow the path. It's blindingly bright, painful.
How are you holding up, Mikkel?
I'll be alright. The sun's past its peak. In a few hours, it won't be nearly as bad.
Don't push yourself, okay?
Alright. The trek is a reminder of just how inconvenient my body always was, and having this chance to experience being alive again comes with both the good parts and the bad. But now is hardly the time to complain about my sensitivity to the sun.
Get on with the story. Chop chop.
It's not long before we reach the clearing, a small cottage surrounded by a small garden coming into view. And crouching by a flower bed, picking flowers, is a flaxen-haired girl.
Oh, she's cute.
Are you Nell? Though several details of her appearance don't match my memory of her, she still has that distinct hair. It could be nobody else. This Nell is considerably thinner and looks rather frail.
I mean, yeah. Not the exact same Nell that we know from the first door.
The effects of her being ill, I presume.
Who are you?
My name is Mikkel. I have a few questions to ask of you. Can we talk for a bit?
She is right to be suspicious here.
I would have thought she'd have said something by now.
You are being way too blunt, Mikkel. You've gone and scared her.
What else am I supposed to say?
You have to approach slowly, carefully. Go on, give her a smile. A nice, soft smile.
Smile, Alright. I'm only here to talk. There's nothing to be afraid of, my dear.
Okay. That is definitely not a nice smile. Oh, God, why? I can't even see it, and I can still tell.
What did you expect from me? I can't just smile on demand.
The sudden cutesy music
put me off so bad.
All right.
It threw me through the loop. All right. I gotta get into the mood here.
It's a bad man. A bad man has come to kidnap me. Save me, dearest Mel, before this bad man does bad things to me.
No, god damn it.
Calm down, please. I'm not going to do anything to you.
Off to a bad start. God damn it. Poor Mikkel.
Don't come any closer. I know you're trying to do bad things to me.
First off, you do not know that. I haven't even done anything yet. Or I won't. Or
this little brat.
Okay, I retract my earliest comment. You are a little brat.
God damn it.
I'm not going to do bad things to you. I couldn't even if I wanted to. Okay, that's not even a thing you should comment on, man. God damn. Come on! Mikkel!
Do I have to smack you around? Don't move or I'll call the guards on you.
Guards? As far as I know, you're alone here. But yeah, sure, go ahead.
Please calm down. I mean you no harm, honestly.
That's what all bad men say.
Well, she got you there, Mikkel. She got you there.
Oh my god,
bro, we are not getting anywheres here. God damn it.
Giselle, don't just watch. This would be a fantastic time for a little advice.
Got it. Maybe she'll calm down if you mention Mel.
You are a genius!
This is so stupid.
It's a cute moment, sure, but it's also stupid. Stupidly cute.
There we go. That's the way to phrase it.
I'm a friend of Mel's. He was telling me about you, and how you wanted someone to talk to. He asked me to keep you company.
Mel asked you to talk to me?
He did. Do you trust me now?
So that makes you his friend, then?
As much as it pains me to admit it. Mikkel!
What on earth possessed you to say that?
Slip of the tongue.
You and him... Is that so?
He's thinking about it. If I were her, I would just get as far away from this man as possible. Run, girl, run! Anyways.
Oh, shit.
Okay.
Yes.
You are pretty old to be friends with my Mel.
Well, the way she speaks of my Mel is still the same, apparently. Alright.
Are you really, really, really his friend?
Really?
Then prove it.
The things I do. How so?
If you are really his friend, then you should be able to tell me all about him.
Fuck. Why in God's name would you ever subject me to that?
Do you not like Mel, Mikkel?
That's not it. We're just incompatible.
Okay, here we go.
Oh my gosh, she's quizzing me. Oh god! Please. Please, no. I don't want to pick no out of... Like, I don't want to pick answers out of choices, please. I don't want no bullshittery, please. I'm not taking a test. I'm through with high school and middle school and all that, please. My god, just bring back memories. Alright, I'm done. I'm sorry.
First question. What does my Mel like most of all?
Oh my god, it is. Son of a... I hate this. This is so fucking stupid. Theta! Nell.
You think so too? You think I'm his favorite thing in the whole wide world? I like to believe that's what he thinks. I think it'd be wonderful if I could always be his number one.
Her excessive love for her brother is still out in full force, I see.
Yes, apparently that is still kept here. Okay, well.
Second question. What kind of person is my Mel?
Oh my god. He's a nice guy. He's a sycophant. He's a spineless chump. That one. We're doing it.
How could you?
I misspoke.
You claim you're his friend and then you go and call him spineless? You're not his friend at all, are you?
No, I am. I just believe in order to be friends with someone, you need to acknowledge and accept the good and bad aspects of them. Well, that's what Didier says anyways.
Fair enough, I suppose.
Whew. Okay.
I don't think he's spineless at all, but maybe he acts differently around you. He's my prince, after all.
I'm kind of interested to see what she does with me saying, that he's a sycophant. Let me see. What's her reaction here?
Does he really come off that way? I mean, sure, he is nice to everyone, but is that such a bad thing?
Okay. Yeah, that okay. It clearly states that you're wrong there. Yeah. Okay. I just want to see about this one, then.
That's right. He's a very nice guy. He can have his head in the clouds sometimes, but other than that, he's perfect. You know your stuff.
Okay, that was clearly the right answer. Alright, well. That last one. That seems like a neutral answer. While the second choice that you had to make, that was the bad one. Okay, so, yeah, alright. There's a bad, there's a neutral, and there's an obvious, correct, good answer. Okay. I see, so it basically doesn't matter, per se, but obviously you're just gonna get a bad reaction if you do the worst incorrect answer. Interesting. Okay, cool.
To be honest, I was just saying what you wanted to hear.
Blasphemy.
Me and my big mouth.
Yeah, you do have a big mouth there.
Anyways.
Okay, final question. Describe what he looks like to me.
I try not to scrutinize other men. He is decently handsome. I'm far better looking.
You know, come on.
I am far better looking than that little runt. I am a beautiful, handsome man. Thank you very much.
That's not what I asked.
Why does she look so depressed? Ah!
You're just so full of surprises today, aren't you, Mikkel?
Oh, well, I'm sorry, Giselle. Am I wrong? Am I an ugly fucker?
Perhaps I am. I'll reload.
Alright, I'm loading up. I'm sorry.
I thought I was handsome. I guess not. Well, fuck me, apparently. Fuck this guy named Mikkel. No one cares about Mikkel. Everyone loves the handsomest Mel, apparently.
Well, fuck me bent over sideways, bitch.
Who am I talking to? I I don't know. I'm sorry. Okay. Yeah, I'm talking to everyone. Even you! Okay. Continuing on.
Isn't he? He's like a modern-day Adonis.
No idea who that might be. Is that God? Probably. I'll look it up later.
That might be a bit of a stretch.
I would say so.
Mel could be a prince in a fairy tale. He's got the most perfect face.
May I ask you something?
Hmm?
You do realize he's still growing, right? And that can change a man in unimaginable ways. He could end up 2 heads taller, shoulders twice as broad, and covered in muscle before you realize what's happened. And body hair, lots of that. Facial hair as thick as these woods.
Why is she... Okay, why is he mentioning this to a little girl? Especially her brother. I mean, her sister. I mean, his sister. Shut the fuck up. Sinikle, shut the fuck up.
I'm sorry!
Would you still consider Mel your prince if that happened to him?
Mel with a beard and muscles? I won't have it. That's not my Mel at all.
You are heading into dangerous waters, Mel.
My Mel will never ever grow a beard. No. I'll pray every day to make sure of it. And he won't get all big and muscly either. There's nothing princely about any of that.
I mean, you say that now, but I mean... Things change for women as well, even tastes in men. Okay, I'm just saying.
You may think, at your young age, you may think thin men are handsome, but I'm just saying, you might think muscular is all that and hot when you get older. I mean, tastes in men or women change as you get older. I'm just saying, okay?
Of course she doesn't know that because she's still young, but she'll figure it out once she gets older.
As well as the young Mel, his chase will...
My throat.
his tastes will change as well.
Just human bodily functions and all that. Chemistry. Biology. What are we talking about? Who am I? Where am I?
Who are you people?
Okay, I'm done.
I wouldn't mind some muscles myself.
Hmm? Right?
Out of curiosity, did you ever want to be buff like that, Mikkel?
Well, yes, of course. Every man wants to be strong and well-built.
Not every man, but... Yeah. Yeah.
What am I answering? I don't know.
I don't think the beefy look would work on you. Well, that's the last of my questions. You are not a complete stranger, it seems. Sure, why not? You can be my Mel's friend.
Why, thank you, my dear.
This is great. I was sure you were a bad man.
Not bad at all, nope. Why is it that my first impression everyone has of me is never that I'm someone decent?
I'm not gonna comment on that.
Nah.
Any friend of Mel's must be a good person. No, an amazing person.
That's quite the faith you have in him.
Why wouldn't I? He's my big brother.
That's some circular logic. Okay.
Is it just you? Is Mel not coming?
He's rather busy at the moment.
Oh. He always has something to take care of, that Mel. He's hardly given me any attention these past couple months.
Yikes. Okay, here.
But that's okay, because today I've got you to keep me company.
Yes, you do. I can't stay long, though.
All right, just stay until sundown, then. You had something you wanted to ask me, didn't you? Well, if you're a good enough friend, I'll tell you anything you want to know.
And how do I go about that?
Talking. Lots and lots of talking. You have to keep me entertained.
Right. You're asking far too much of me.
She's not asking much at all. She just wants to talk. Come on.
Do you think someone who spent 13 years in isolation knows the first thing about holding a pleasant conversation?
Hey now, I was there for a year of that. I'll help you come up with topics, so go on. Do you not want to talk to me?
No, no, I do. I'm just not much of a conversationalist.
Okay, then instead of talking, you can sing. I've never seen a minstrel before, but I've always wanted to know what kinds of songs they sing. Will you show me?
I've never seen one myself either, but I have heard secondhand accounts of the songs of traveling jungliers. Very well then. I'll teach you a song an old acquaintance of mine heard while traveling.
Whee! I can't wait.
Here goes.
Oh, thank God, Skip. I was not prepared to sing at all. Oh, terrible. Okay. Well...
You're all not critics! Get off my ass!
Okay, he failed. Okay, well.
What a miserable performance. The silence is certainly deafening.
I'm shocked. I don't think I've ever heard someone sing so badly.
Me neither.
I'm flabbergasted.
Let's hear you try, then.
That's enough singing for today. I don't want my ears to fall off.
What a vicious little girl.
I know, right? Goddamn.
I know, let's bake something.
Bake? Something?
Yep. Come on inside. I made some nice jam earlier today, and I want to make it into a pretty little pie. You get to help me with that.
I'm not too much of a...
Come on, get the move on. You either help, or you don't get to be my friend.
As you wish. This is not going to end very well.
That's Giselle, not Mikkel, but okay. God damn it.
Son of a bitch.
This is not going to end very well.
No, it's not. This is terrible. I'm doing terrible here.
Please.
Send help. Okay, all right, okay. Is there anything this man can do?
Son of a bitch.
Unbelievable. Absolutely unbelievable. How on earth do you manage to turn a pie into this monstrosity?
I gave it to my best shot. What do you want from me?
There's only one explanation. You are possessed.
It is. I can't. Motherfucker, I am possessed by you! You are haunting me! Like, literally!
Good grief! It's true, he is, but I'm a perfectly good chef. Mikkel is just naturally terrible at it.
God, can this go any worse? Get any worse, more like.
I can't give this to Mel. Jerk, dimwit, loser.
I'm sorry. Well, I guess we've got no choice but to eat it ourselves.
I'll set the table.
What?
And I'll make us some tea while I'm at it. You know, I've always dreamed of this, sitting around a table with a friend, having snacks and just talking.
Oh.
Yep. And for that, I can deal with a little awful, disgusting pie. It's just too bad I couldn't share it with my Mel, too.
I see.
For all her complaining, she seems to be enjoying herself. I can only imagine how lonely she is out here. While she may act all bright and cheerful, beneath it is a real sense of isolation.
Damn. Not only the comparison, but the fact that they have something in common. Damn. Holy shit.
And the same can be said about the girl behind the first door. As vivacious and pushy as she could be, you could see hints of loneliness behind it all.
Her brother was practically all she had while she lived in that mansion. But if I were to guess, that's not the life she really wanted. I bet she would have preferred to be all... What? Preferred to be able to go out and play with friends.
Being born into a noble family takes away a lot of your freedom.
Even in such drastically different time periods, she's still the same girl inside. Actually, maybe the parallels extend beyond her as a person and into the courses of her two different lives.
Perhaps that means all those who were reconstructed at Morgana's wish are destined to lead similar lives. Though, destined might be putting it too nicely. Nell? I would be glad to lend you my ear, if you would like. You can talk about the weather, or your brother, anything you want.
You will? Great, take a seat. I've got lots I want to talk about. More than you can possibly imagine.
Aw, ain't that cute.
And you'll never guess what Mel said next. That I mean more to him than anyone in the world.
Oh god. It goes on for hours and hours. It's a monologue!
So I'm growing flowers out in the garden, right? Well... When I've got enough of them, I'm going to make a big bouquet and give it to Mel.
Oh, great.
Back at home, we've got this really, really big yard with this huge tree we used to take naps under when it was nice out. So what do you think about the tea I made? A flower petals, what really ties it all together. Oh, and you won't believe what happened after that.
Okay. She's drowning out my ears.
Great!
Care for another cup of tea? I'll make as much as you can drink.
No, thank you. I am fine, though. I feel like all I did was nod and listen. For many hours. And the bulk of it was about Mel, no less.
Well, duh.
I haven't talked about that much in ages. Time sure flew by, huh? The sun's starting to set.
Do you and the nun not speak much?
We do, but it's kind of... I don't know. Not really the same with her. It just feels, I guess, like she's too important for me to waste her time. Being the lady in charge of the church, and pretty much the whole estate.
And what about Mel? Does he not visit you very often?
No, he does. He comes to see me a lot.
Then why?
He hasn't been himself lately. My old Mel would always happily listen to whatever I had to say. But now he seems kind of distracted. It sounds like he's really busy. When he visits, he doesn't stay for long, and he has to go back to the mansion at night. I'll try to get him to stay longer, but it just never works. And he always avoids the question when I ask him why he can't. It feels like he's hiding something.
Oh, well. About that.
Knowing what he's hiding, I can understand why he wouldn't want to talk about it.
True.
He could never tell his precious little sister that he had two other men have a girl locked up in the tower, and that he's stealing her blood for her sake.
I wish things could have stayed the way they were before.
The way they were before.
When it was just the two of us living together. I know we are more stable here, and I can get the medicine I need from the church, but I'd rather stay being sick than be so alone.
You said you came here around 6 months ago.
Yep. And it was just the two of us before that. Well, before that, at our old house, we had a bunch of servants. And I never really liked it there either. With that many people around, I just felt more alone. I liked it so much better than it was just me and Mel.
Is that really what you want? To be sick? And in constant pain.
It's better than being alone. Mel just doesn't get it. He doesn't understand that the loneliness is so much worse. Or maybe it's just a guy thing.
Yeah. As a guy myself, Just nod and say yeah.
They don't get what it's like to be ignored. What it feels like to be left in the dark, not knowing anything.
We don't understand, no. We think saving their lives matters above all.
Huh?
Even if there's a cost to saving that life. We are incapable of gauging how great it is. We are unable to see how egotistical, how self-serving our actions are.
Are you talking about yourself?
The same could be said about Mel as well, I imagine.
Mel's still around, though. He's there, but it's like he's trying to avoid me. All I want is for him to be here, to be with me. That's all I really want. He doesn't even have to be a perfect fairy tale prince.
Have you ever told him that?
What?
Have you ever told him that he doesn't have to be the perfect brother? that you'd be happy with just having him here. Have you ever put those feelings into words?
I'm always telling him I want him around.
And that he doesn't have to be your prince to do so.
He's already said he will be my prince. And he always smiles whenever I talk about it. So how am I supposed to turn around and say he doesn't have to be my prince anymore?
I know it's not your intention to force an ideal image onto him, but unconsciously, subconsciously, that's what you are doing when you talk like that.
Damn, we're getting into the real shit right here. Facts. Facts, man, facts. I like that. Character development! Well, part of it, anyway.
And Mel, he's trying to meet those expectations. Actually, he may not be conscious of it himself. And he just believes deep down that that's the kind of person he's supposed to be. Or, more accurately, he seems to have the need to make himself look good to others. He believes that if he's good to others, they'll be good to him in return.
Am I a burden?
I can assure you, he's better off with you around.
But I am a burden to him right now, aren't I? Be honest with me.
Yes, you are.
Does Mel not like me anymore? Is that why he's been avoiding me?
I promise you, that is not the case. At the very least, he's doing what he's doing now because of how much he cares about you.
You promise?
I promise.
I love him. I love my Mel so very much. Too much, in fact. To be honest, I know I do. I understand that, really. I know I'm making his life difficult. But Mel's all I have. He's the only person I can latch on to. And I can't control my feelings.
Ooh, damn. It can be difficult to tame your emotions at your age. There's nothing wrong with that. However, you should have taken stock of those emotions, sorted through everything you've got on your mind, and then sat down with him to talk it out. Even if those things you feel seem wrong or unspeakable, you should have opened up to him, taken the time to figure out what works best for the both of you. You two needed to face the things you carried in your heart. The things your brother carried in his. By not doing so, you end up never quite on the same page. Small misunderstandings piling up until it all comes crashing down. If they had just talked it out, communicated their feelings to one another, maybe their tragedy could have been avoided, even with Morgana's curse in play. If Nell had only had the chance to come to grips with her feelings for Mel, then maybe things wouldn't have escalated the way they did. Her actions that night were arguably hysteric. But she wasn't always like that.
True. Things very much escalated, yeah. I remember that. Yikes.
I'm sorry. That was out of line. None of this is any of my business, I know.
No need to apologize. Well, a very curious man, you know that?
Huh?
We only met a couple of hours ago, but you talk like you've known me my whole life. It's like you can hear everything I'm thinking, see everything in my heart.
About that.
Did Mel tell you all of that?
No. No, he did not tell me much.
I didn't think so. He doesn't know me that very well. It's not too late, is it? If I talk to him, really tell him how I feel, do you think Mel will listen?
I know he will.
It won't make things worse? It won't make him uncomfortable?
There is a chance that rifts may form at first. But those cracks can be filled again. And I promise you, the result will be something much better than if you had held it in. It would all work out.
Okay. Next time I see Mel, I'll tell him. I'll tell him he doesn't have to try to be my prince.
Good.
You really are a curious man. You are the first person to ever talk to me like I'm a real person. Everyone loves to say how sweet and adorable I am, but that's it. I was only ever their make-believe princess.
You are a real person, I assure you.
Thanks. You know, after talking to you, I'm feeling a whole lot better. Like, I could do anything. I'm glad you came by today.
And I am glad I could meet you in person.
It's weird. It really feels like we've known each other our entire lives.
I've known you for some time. Or perhaps I should say, what you will become.
Huh?
Oh no. Ignore me, dear.
Was that supposed to be a pickup line?
No.
Bad, Mikkel. I'm still too young for that.
Says the one who has love interests for the brother.
Okay.
All right there, dearie. No, I wasn't.
And now you're getting flustered.
I swear, that's not what that was.
I know. Jeez, do you really think I trust you that little?
Sorry.
Ooh, I just had the most wonderful idea.
Oh?
Yep. Instead of being my friend, I'll let you be something even better.
Okay, what would that be?
You are my second brother.
Second brother?
Brother is much, much more special to me than a friend. Though obviously you can't be my number one.
Damn. I mean, I know it's just story. I know it's fiction and all that. You know what I mean. But kind of weird and off-putting. They just met the same day, and already he's like a second brother to him, you know? I mean, to her, sorry. A little weird. But it's a sweet thought, sure. But still, it's a little weird. I know it's just part of the story, but, yeah, well. Whatever. Let's just roll with it, shall we? I'm blanking. Sorry. There was no I in there. Well, there was, but not in the position where it was put. Okay, and on.
Shut up!
She's taking a liking to you. This is good for us.
I'm not sure how I feel about her putting so much trust in me so quickly, though.
The amount of time it takes isn't important. What matters is that you listen to her, you understand her, and you treated her like a real person.
Okay. Okay. Actually, point taken. Actually, point taken. All right,
never mind. I retract my earlier statement. In her eyes, you are someone she can depend on. Do you not want me as your sister?
Actually, I was the youngest child. But having a younger sibling would be,
would be what? Come on, spit it out.
It would be rather nice.
You bet it would. Who wouldn't want an adorable little sister like me?
That's a bit narcissistic, wouldn't you say?
Well, it's true, isn't it? Go on, tell me I'm adorable, dearest of Mikhail.
Oh, shucks. Damn. Come on, smile.
What? Well, don't just stare at me. If my Mel were here, he wouldn't bat an eye.
Please, do not compare me to him. You know, now might be a good time to tell her about Morgana.
You think?
Part of me feels like I would be taking advantage of her newly earned trust, but it will certainly be easier to bring up now, while she holds me in such high regard. She's much more likely to believe me.
You are right. I agree, now's probably the best chance you'll get. Especially considering how little time we have.
Right. Ooh. I can't shake that feeling I'm rushing things, but at this point, all I can do is go with it and pray it works out.
If we had the time, I think we'd all like to hold off. Nell looks like she's having so much fun. And even you seem to be enjoying yourself.
No, I'm just...
It's nothing to be ashamed of. I'm having fun watching you myself. Let's do it. Let's tell her about Morgana. We have to do it at some point anyway.
Yes, let's. Nell, do you mind if I ask you a question?
What is it, dearest Mikhail? Ask me anything you want.
Have you heard of something called a saint's blood?
You mean the medicine?
Oh, shit. Wait. She knows about it? Wait, hold up. What? Wait, what? Sorry, I'll just continue on.
Yes, except it's not actually...
I know, yeah.
She knows. The music stopped too. Yikes. Okay. This is quite the conundrum here. Okay, so she knows. Doesn't look like it really bothers her, I think. Well, maybe with that expression, maybe. Sorry, I'll just continue on. Alright, sorry.
I know, yeah, it's actually the saint's blood, not medicine. But no telling.
You... what?
One day before we moved here, when it was just me and Mel, the saintess came to visit. My mind... Oh, yeah, that's...
I forgot. I actually forgot that detail. Whoopsies.
My mind had been all foggy for a long time, like I was not quite asleep, but not quite awake either. But when I heard her soft, pleasant voice, the fog cleared a bit. And then she performed a miracle for me. Blood is awful and gross and terrible, but the Saintess's, hers is different. Hers is pure.
So you are saying you know everything, Nell? About the observation tower and...
Huh? Okay. So she thinks she's giving it voluntarily. No, Dolly, no. Oh, boy. Okay, so she doesn't know this part. Okay. Okay, I get you now. I get it. Okay, well, whoops.
Huh? The tower? What about it?
That's where they keep her.
What? No, the Saintess is always in the chapel. And she stays here with me. And she comes back at nights. What? Huh. In fact, she should be here any minute now. So she thinks the Saintess...
is the nun. And not Morgana.
Oof. Trickery afoot. That's not good.
No, Nell. That blood comes from...
I'm really, really grateful for her. She didn't just perform the one miracle. She's been taking care of me while I'm here, too. So whenever I see her, I always say thank you. I thank her for sharing her blood with me. And she always says, it's nothing, with a big smile.
Nell, no. The nun has no idea. She just assumes Nell's thanking her for giving her the medicine.
I owe the Saintess my life.
No, Nell. She's not the one you should be grateful to.
Huh?
The girl you owe your life to has been locked up, suffering, and alone even as we speak.
But the Saintess is at the church.
The girl who came to visit you is not the nun everyone calls the Saintess. Her name is Morgana.
What are you talking about, Mikkel? The Saintess is locked up? Stop that. I have no idea what you're talking about.
Everything I'm telling you is the truth. Please, believe me. While you were lying in bed, sick and barely conscious, did you get a good look at the Saintess who gave you her blood? You didn't, did you? You couldn't make out any details about your mind... because your mind was a haze. And then, when you arrived at the estate, you met a woman who people called the Saintess, giving out medication known as Saint's Blood. So you assumed she was the one who had cured you. That's the story you choose to believe.
If what you're saying is true, then where is the other Saintess, the one who came to see me?
At the top of the mansion's observation tower. The door to the tower is locked. She's imprisoned there.
And how do you know this?
Because... it wouldn't be wise to tell her I'm from the future just yet. That would only serve to confuse her further. All I need to convince her of right now is that Morgana is being held in the tower. There's an idea. Perhaps I can borrow from the story the white-haired girl told Mel. I received a letter.
A letter?
There's a single window, far out of reach, in the chamber at the top of the tower. A dove flew in through the window, and so she wrote a letter, trying... No, not trying. There's no R in there. Sorry. Tying it to the bird's leg, and releasing it in the hopes someone would come to set her free. That letter ended up in my hands.
If that's the case, then who locked her up? Was it the Saintess, the one I know?
No. I don't believe the nun is aware. I think she is simply doing her job in good faith.
Then who?
Mikkel.
I know very well.
Whoops.
No!
Backlog. Right.
That's what I'm about to say will likely crush her, but I can't let that stop me.
Who would do such a terrible thing?
Nell, I want you to brace yourself for what I'm about to say. There are three men participating in Morgana's imprisonment.
I think she already has a feeling that she knows one of the three names you're going to say. It's not going to be good. Not going to be good.
And one of those three is your brother, Mel. I understand that that's the last thing you wanted to hear. But please believe me, I would not say something so upsetting lightly. I wish to save Morgana, the true saint. And I would like your assistance. Without your help, I can't get her out of the tower. I need you to get through to Mel, otherwise both he and Morgana will remain entrapped.
That's not true.
Nell.
You're lying, you have to be. My Mel would never do something so horrible. You're a terrible liar.
It's true, I swear to you.
You think I'm going to believe that? But my Mel... My Mel's an amazing, wonderful person. He's not cruel and evil. He's good and kind like a prince. And a prince would never lock someone up.
I know you're not blind, Nell. You can see that all your prince talk has been putting pressure on him.
So? You think that's going to change my mind? He has no reason to do any of that.
But he does, Nell. He's certainly not happy about it, no, but he's doing it for you.
What do you mean?
He needs her blood to keep you healthy, yes? So, to ensure he always had a supply...
But, no, he...
And despite that... Saint's blood probably doesn't even have healing properties. No one benefits from doing this. Not you, not Mel, and certainly not Morgana herself. And I don't think anyone can stop him except you.
Mel won't listen to me.
Did you not just say you would talk things through with him?
Oh, I'm losing it a little bit. Sorry about that. Gotta have to wrap this up real quick.
Just shut up. Stop talking already. I'm done listening to you.
Nell.
I'll never believe you. You're not my brother anymore. You're just a horrible, horrible person. Who do you think you are to march in here and try to make my Mel into a bad guy? And after I made you my second brother. What's wrong with you? I trusted you. I ate nasty pie and had tea with you.
I can't hold a straight face while... Okay, well... God damn it. Aw.
But you're just a mean, evil man here to turn me against my Mel?
I know you don't want to believe me. But I'm telling you the truth, every word. I beg you to open your eyes. Ask him yourself. If you don't believe me, then ask Mel about Morgana. I guarantee you, you'll panic.
Enough! Enough already! Get out of here! Get out this instant!
Nell.
Don't say my name. Just go away. Get out of here. Now. I don't want to see you ever again. I should have chased you off the moment I saw you. Get out. Now.
I pray you can find it in yourself to open your eyes and face the truth. Get out! One last thing before I go, Nell.
Oh. Oh, what's happening? What's happening? What's going on? What? What transpired? No? What? What just transpired? What was that? Wait, hold on. Wait, what? Oh, maybe they're keeping it secret from us. For a reveal later on. Dun dun dun. Okay. Anyways.
It was my only option. I know that. But I feel like all I accomplished by telling her was bringing her more pain. It's a difficult balance.
You just have to pray that you were able to get through to her. I'm sure she'll come around.
If only we had a little more time. In 3 days, it will all be over. Morgana and the entire web of people connected to her will die. That's not enough time. Let's return to the mansion and look for Mel. I would like to speak with him. If there's a chance we can get even the smallest bit of Nell's feelings through to him, maybe he'll have a change of heart.
Hopefully.
It's hardly going to be elegant, but it's what must be done.
Amen. All right. With that being said, we're going to end it there. I'm going to save, and I'm going to go back, and then I'm going to go into the title screen. That was certainly something. Whew. I think altogether this came to about an hour plus of video. I kind of wanted to start doing less than that per video. Like, limiting it down to 30 minutes of video. I'm not sure, though. That might be the way to go, though, in order to upload more frequently. But in either case, I'll think about it. Certainly a good little segment of that chapter there. We got quite a bit done. Well, Mikael did. I'm just mouthing off. It was cute, but didn't last long, of course, because now we have to get into the nitty-gritty of some stuff. And I look forward to that, and I hope you all do as well. So stick around for the next one, and I will see you all next time. All right, see you then. Bye-bye.